Hello everyone, this is Akash here from bendiscuity.cf, and in this Blender tutorial, I'm going to be showing you how to create this low poly camera in Blender. Now I'm going to be showing you how to make this a bit cartoony by adding this nice black outline around the entire camera, and I'm going to be using the freestyle feature in Blender Cycles to do this. I'm going to be using Blender version 2.77 for this. And yeah, let's get started with this. So I'm going to open up a new scene in Blender. We're going to be using this cube as the main body of the camera. But before that, let's get some reference images so that we can start modeling the camera. So I found out a few reference images from the site of this camera. Now I'm going to be using this camera design just because I like the look and the design of the camera. It looks really retro, and yeah, it looks really nice camera to me. And you can use different styles of camera if you want, but I'm going to be creating this camera itself. So I'm going to be using this image right here, this front image, and this side view of the camera image. So I'm going to be using this and this to model out the camera. You can also use this back image if you want to, but I don't think it's necessary in my scene because yeah, we're not even going to see the behind portion of the camera. So yeah, let's load these images in Blender. So press N and then come down and then check background images and then click on add image, and then now we can open the image which we want to use. So I'm going to open up the camera image. So this is the front image. So I'm going to go to the front view and then the orthographic view just to see how it looks like. So as you can see, we have the camera front image loaded up, and I'm just going to change the axis to be front so that we can see it only when we are in the front view. Okay, so now let's basically start giving this cube the shape of the main camera body. So I'm gonna just press S and then X, scale it in the X axis, and then make it big. And then I'm gonna use this red arrow just to move it over here. Okay, then come in the edit mode by pressing the tab key, and then press A, then press B to box select this bottom row of edges, and then just move them down. Okay, like that. Do the same thing with the top row of vertices, just to move it till there. Now as you can see, there's a bit of extrusion over here, so you're gonna do that by adding in a few loop cuts. So press Ctrl R and then just move this loop cut over here. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna now select this vertices over here, these vertices, and then press E to extrude and then move it over here like that. And that's fine. So now we have the basic body of the camera. Now let's go to the left view to load in the other side view image of our camera. So I'm going to press add image over here, click on open, open the other image which is the side view of the camera, and I'm going to change this axis to be left so that we can see it only when we are in the left view. Now as you can see, we don't have the camera or the cube properly positioned. Now it's a good idea not to move the cube to match the image, but move the image to match the cube. So if that doesn't make sense, I'm just going to show you how to do that. So I'm going to use this X and Y values just to position the image so that it matches the cube. So just make sure you're matching the top and the top part and the base of the cube. So I'm just going to move it like that. You can also fiddle with the size value. I'm just going to make this a bit lesser. Somewhere like that, I guess, should be fine. And yeah, that's actually looking fine to me. Yeah, that's fine. I'm just gonna move it a bit more smaller. Not to be too neat about this, just because we are just using this as a reference image. So you don't have to be too neat. So as you can see, now I have it properly positioned, and it's matching the body of the camera in the left view also. So I'm gonna go to the edit mode, and then I'm gonna select these vertices over here, and just gonna move them just so that it matches the dimensions of the camera again, as I told you. And I guess it's fine over here, so I'm just gonna leave it like that. So now we have our camera, main body of the camera ready. Now let's actually add in the lens on the camera. So we're gonna have the lens over here, the big lens. So I'm gonna use a cylinder for that. So press Shift A, Mesh, Cylinder, and then press F6 to change a few properties. I'm going to change the vertices count to be 8, and change the cap fill type to be nothing, And actually, no, vertices should be 12, not 8. So I've put 12 vertices just because this is going to give us that nice low poly effect on the lens of our camera. So it's going to look good. That's why I'm using 12 as a vertices count. Now press R and then X, the 90, to rotate it in the x-axis by 90 degrees. Come to the top view and move it out like such. When I come in the front view and then move it by pressing G to the center, just so that it matches the image somewhat like this. And I guess that much is fine. And above that much should be fine. So yeah, as you can see, it's nearly matching the outer boundary of the camera. So if you come in the left view now, as you can see now, this the left side view of the camera has a really large lens, as you can see. Now I don't want the lens to look that big, so I'm just gonna keep it this much, just because I want it to look small. So I'm just gonna keep it this much, I guess. That's fine. I'm just gonna move it a bit inside and scale it in the y-axis by pressing S, then Y. Scale it like that. Move it a bit outside. Scale it a bit. I guess that much is fine. Yeah, it's fine. So now we have a lens of the camera. Now it's actually really thin, so let's add in some thickness. So for that, I'm going to be using the solidify modifier. So come to the modifiers tab, add modifier, and then select the solidify modifier. Change this thickness value to be 0.091. That should be fine. And as you can see, now we have some thickness. And I'm going to actually create the lens now. So as you can see now in the final render, we have a nice blue lens over here. So I'm going to create that. Okay, so for that, come to the edit mode by pressing the tab key. And then I'm going to select the outer row of vertices by pressing Alt. And then, right-clicking on the vertices like that. Then press F to add in a face. And then press P and select selection. This is going to separate the face from the cylinder. Remove the solidify modifier and then move this inwards by holding down this green arrow and then moving it. So as you can see, now we have the lens, which is a bit inside in the camera. So that's looking good. And now we need the inner boundary of the camera. So as you can see, I have a nice white boundary and an inner black boundary in the lens. So let's add in the black boundary. So come to the front view and then press Shift D to duplicate the cylinder, and then press S and then Shift Y so it doesn't scale in the y-axis, and then scale it a bit inwards somewhat like that. Okay, so as you can see, now we have our inner boundary created now. And I'm gonna just decrease this thickness to be 0.07, just because I don't want it to be too thick, and I guess that much is fine. So now we have a lens ready. And now let's start creating the other parts of the camera. As you can see, we have a bit of more decorations over here, so we are going to add those in. So for that, I'm going to just select this outer cylinder over here, this lens. And then I'm just going to also select this, the lens itself, the face of the lens, I should say. And then press Shift D to duplicate it and then place it over here. Press S to scale and then make it smaller so that it just covers this this thing right here. Okay, just about that much. I should be fine. You can see I have that in the final render also. It's looking good. I'm just gonna move this outside like that. Should be fine. And move this a bit inwards. Okay. I'll do that the same thing. So press Shift D. Move this new object over here, just near the lens. Don't make sure that this object and the lens don't intersect. So that's fine, and yeah, that's looking good. Now let's do this thing right here, this cubic thing. I don't know what it has, what it is, I don't know. I guess it's the lens to just view what you're clicking. Anyways, whatever it is, let's create it. So add in a cube, so press Shift A mesh cube, and press S, and then Z to scale it so it matches the dimensions of this thing right here. I'm just gonna move it like that, so as you can see, it's proper. Then press S and then Y so it's not that thick. I'm just gonna move it outside like such. Okay, that's fine. Come to the front view, put it to the edit mode by pressing the tab key, and then select this face right here and press X and select faces to delete the outer face. Now select the inner row of faces. So come to the wireframe mode again, make sure faces are selected and then press Alt and then right click on this area right here so that all the faces are selected like that. And then come in the front view, then press E to extrude, then scale it inwards by pressing Shift Y. Okay, so that it scales in both in all the axes except the Y axis. Okay, so as you can see now we have it properly done. However, there's some problem with the extrusion of it. I don't know why. Let me try that again. Okay, fine. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna add in a solidify modifier then, just because it's so not coming properly. So that's a simple thing to get over it. I'm gonna give it a bit of thickness as well. That's nice. Let's add in the face in this also. So I'm gonna select this outer row of edges and then press F and then press P and selection to remove this face. Remove the solidify modifier from this and then move this face inside. And yeah, make sure only the face is selected. This thing needs to have a solidify modifier. Okay, fine. So I'm just gonna move this inwards. That's fine. Okay, so now we have the other part of the camera as well. Now let's do the same thing for this thing. So I'm just gonna duplicate this. So I'm gonna press B and select all these objects right here, and press Shift D, move it over here, and I'm just gonna scale it. Okay, scale in the x-axis to match it. Okay, there you go. You have this part also ready. I'm just gonna move it outside now, and move this inner face a bit inwards just because it's too outside. So that's fine. And as you can see now, it's looking much better. Now let's model these things right here. So to do that, I'm gonna add in a cylinder again. So press Shift A, mesh, cylinder, and this time I'm gonna change the cap fill type to be n-gon just because I need some face. So I'm gonna press S and scale it inwards just like that. Okay, and I'm just gonna move it down like such. Okay, that's fine. I'm just gonna scale it also. Okay, so now let's do the let's model this thing right here. So I'm just gonna go to the edit mode, press A to deselect all the edges, and then press B and then select only the top row of edges. Then press E to extrude and then scale it in the scale it. So press S, move it outside somewhat like that, and then press E and then extrude it on top. So as you can see, we have the basic shape of that thing nicely done. And then do the same thing again for this object also. So press Shift A, cylinder, and I'm just gonna scale it just to match the dimensions of this thing a bit, somewhat like that. Move it to the base like that. That's fine. And let's do the modeling again. So in the edit mode, I'm gonna extrude, scale it outside, and then press E to extrude, and again E, scale it inwards, and then press E again, and then move it up. So as you can see now, we have both the parts of the camera. It's looking much more better now. Okay. Now the final part is this small circular area over here. So for that also I'm gonna be using these objects right here. So I'm gonna press B and select them, press Shift D to duplicate it and place it over here like such. I'm just gonna make sure it's matching the location and size of that. I'm just gonna move it inwards again, and that's fine. So as you can see, we have modeled out all the parts of the camera, I guess, and it's looking good. Okay, so yeah, now let's start by adding in the materials. So I'm going to go to the Cycles rendering engine and then change this to be the materials tab, and now let's add in the materials. So since this is gonna be a little cartoonish scene, I'm not going to be using any glossy shader in this. We're going to use proper diffuse, and also as you can see, I have used almost desaturated colors in my scene, and this looks really good in a cartoonish scene, so that's fine. So let's do that. So I'm gonna select the main body of the camera and then click on use nodes to add in the material to it. So as you can see, the camera has actually two materials First is this silver material, and then we have this nice leather material. So to do that, we need to actually divide this cube into different parts. So come in the edit mode, then press Ctrl R to add in a horizontal loop cut, and then move the loop cut over here. Do the same thing with the base over here, and that much I guess is fine. So yeah, this is gonna be the gray material, I guess. So we're gonna give this a gray material, and the color of this is gonna be, so if you wanna use the same color which I'm gonna use, click on this hex tab right here and change the value of this to be a CE, CE, and then CE. It's gonna give you a slight gray material, a gray color. That's actually fine, so I'm just gonna drop it in the viewport color as well. Okay, that's fine. So by default, we're gonna have this gray material on this cube, but then some parts need to have that black material. To do that, click on this plus button right here, and then click on new. Change the material's name to be black. Oops, we have it in a wrong case. Okay, fine, that's fine. And change this color over here to be, this time to be 27, 27, and then 27. It's gonna give us a bit of a desaturated black color. So I'm just gonna drop it in over here just to see it. So we have another material, but you can't see it on the object, because we need to assign the parts where we want this black to appear. So I'm gonna come in the face select mode and then come in the edit mode and then press Alt and then right click on these row of faces over here in the middle to select all of them at once, and then click on assign to assign this black material to them. As you can see now, that all of them have this nice black color. So that's looking good. Now the hard part of the materials is done. Now we need to just assign these materials itself to the other parts. So for this outer boundary, I think I've used the white color itself, so I'm going to use the gray color for this, like such. For the inner boundary of the lens, I'm going to use the black color. And then for this small thing, I'm going to use the black color as well, for these two. And even for these outer boundaries of these cubes, I guess. Okay. Like such. And as you can see, our camera is coming together now. It's looking good. Now we need one more material for the lens. So I'm going to use a really desaturated color of blue for this. So select the lens, then click on new, change the name of the material to be blue, and change the color to be A1 CC E7. This is going to give us a nice desaturated shade of blue. And I'm going to drop this in the viewport color as well. And as you can see now, we have the nice color for the lens. I'm going to assign the same material to all the other parts of the lens as well. So that is also going to be a lens, I guess. Even this thing right here, it's fine. I'm going to create one more gray shade of a gray color. So that's going to be a silverish color. So I'm going to create a new material, silver. Okay. And then change the color for this one to be 9B. 9B, 9B. This is gonna give us a gray color again. I'll drag this over here. So this shade will be used for these objects right here. Silver, and this thing should be black. I don't know why they're making blue. Same thing for this thing. And all of the other materials should also be the silver color. Okay, that's done. So as you can see now, we have completed our camera. It's looking good. So our camera is done. I'm going to delete this lamp and I'm just going to select all the objects of the camera by pressing B and then drawing a box around them. Come in the front view and I'm going to hide the background images now because I don't think we need them anymore. And I'm going to press S to scale it down a bit, then G, then Z to move them above the grid floor. Just somewhere like that. That's fine. I'm gonna add in a floor to the scene because as you can see, there's no floor and it's gonna look bad. So press Shift A, Mesh, Plane, and I'm gonna come in the front view. That's not positioned the proper place. So press Shift C to bring the cursor at the center, then press Shift A, Mesh, Plane. Scale it by pressing S, then 100, then Enter. And then I'm gonna select these edges right here of the plane, these two edges. And then press E to extrude and move them up in the Z axis, like that. Come in the modifiers tab, add in a subsurf modifier and change the views to be 2. And then select smooth sharing. I guess 3 should be fine. View intended to be 3, that's fine. And then I'm gonna come in the front view. And as you can see, it's not properly positioned. So we're gonna add in some loop cuts to this. So press Ctrl R, one loop cut over there, and one loop cut over there. Okay, so we have a bit of curving over here at the edges. That's gonna look good. Come in the front view again. And then again, reposition this floor just so that it just matches at the base of the camera. So we are done with the background. Now let's actually position the camera somewhat like that. As you can see, we can't even see the full full background. As you can see, we see this world around it. The reason is the range of the camera which it can capture. So change this clipping of the camera to be 200 so that we can see the full thing now. That's better. So I'm just gonna position it like that, like such. That's fine. Okay, change the world's color to be a bit more nice light or white, somewhere like that. That should be fine. Come to the rendered view, and as you can see, we have our camera ready. However, it's looking really blank now. We need to add in some lighting also to make it look better. So I'm just gonna quickly add in a plane, give it a material which is gonna be an emission material with, I guess, the strength to be 5. And then I'm gonna come to the top view, scale it by pressing S and then X and then Y just to make it thinner, and then rotate it, so RX, then G, Z, move it like that, sound like that, should be fine. And then let's see how it looks like. So the strength is a bit low, so I'm gonna change this to be 10. Okay, that's fine, but then we need to reposition it a bit more. Somewhat like that. Yeah. Okay, fine. Oh, that's coming in front of the camera. That's fine. Okay, fine. That's looking better. Now I feel the strength is too much, so I'm going to decrease the strength to be 7. And yeah, that's fine. So we are done with the basic scene of the... Yeah, we are done with the basic scene. We have done all the materials and stuff. So let's save it by pressing Ctrl S. Select the directory, name your file, and save it. So we are done. Now let's actually do the fun part of the tutorial by adding in these nice outline around the object to make it look a bit more cartoonish. So to do that, I'm gonna actually check this freestyle on over here, okay, and then increase the line thickness to be 2. So this line thickness is actually the thickness of the border around the object. Now, once when you have done this, you can come to this scene tab over here, and as you can see, we have a new section called freestyle line set and stuff. So you can control all these values. You can control where the borders are gonna be added by checking and unchecking these things over here. So for this scene, I want the border to be around all the materials and around the object itself. So what I found is you need to uncheck border over here, uncheck crease, and check material boundary. Okay, so once we have done that, you should have a proper freestyle effect. So if you go to the rendered view mode, you can't see any of those things, just because I guess the freestyle isn't rendered in the viewport, I guess. Maybe, I don't know. So yeah, we need to actually give it the proper render so that we can see what the freestyle effect it has. So save it and then give it a render. I guess the sampling is fine for this scene. And then click on render. So this is gonna start rendering. And once it's rendered, we're gonna see the freestyle border which it has added. And we're gonna move it into the compositor to add in a few effects to it, just to make it look even better. So the rendering is finished. Now, as you can see, the effect which it has added, it's looking really good. It has made it look a bit more cartoonish by this outline. And yeah, it's looking much more similar to my final render as well. So that's fine. And also, one more thing we're gonna do, go to the node editor and then the compositor node tree, check use nodes. And I'm just gonna use the photo editing nodes add-on to quickly add in the vignette node, just to add in some vignetting to this. So yeah, I'm just gonna add in a viewer node just to show you what I'm doing. And yeah, press shift A, group vignette. So this node comes with the photo editing nodes pack. If you want this node and the entire collection of nodes, you need to download that pack first. So I'm just going to change the opacity to be 0.7. And I guess we are done with it. So I'm going to go to the, actually I'm just going to come in this over here, UV image editor. And yeah, I'm just going to change to be view node. And as you can see, we have our final scene ready. So it's looking really good. Nice cartoonish camera. Which you can use it in your scenes, and it's looking really good. So that's the end of the tutorial. I hope you found this tutorial useful, and yeah, it was great fun making it. And don't forget to subscribe and leave a comment. It really helps. And yeah, thanks for watching.